Hey everyone, and welcome to World Heritage Journey. For today's video, we're at the Flinders Ranges of Southern Australia. So, this isn't actually a World Heritage Site, yet. It's what's known as a tentative World Heritage Site, part of the process for becoming a full site, which they're hoping to achieve in 2024. So why is it going to become a World Heritage Site? Well, it's not just for the magnificent landscape that you can see behind me. The Flinders Ranges was also home to a key part, a missing piece of the puzzle in the story of evolution. Let's check it out. The Flinders Ranges, also known as Ikara, are located in the east of South Australia on the traditional lands of the Adnyamatya people, the traditional owners and custodians of these lands. Now, at the risk of stating the obvious, Australia is old, incredibly old, and with almost no earthquakes, volcanoes, or tectonic plates altering the landscape, many parts of Australia have remained almost completely unchanged for hundreds of millions of years, particularly the spectacular Flinders Ranges. It's this permanent, unchanging nature that makes the ranges so special and so important. For a century, biologists had puzzled over what's known as the Cambrian explosion, an event 500 million years ago when complex life forms began appearing quite suddenly in the fossil record. Because of evolution, there must surely have been an intermediate step between the forms of life like bacteria and algae that existed beforehand, and the enormous variety and complexity of the Cambrian explosion. Enter the Flinders Ranges. In 1946, a geologist named Reginald Sprigg discovered a treasure trove of fossils in the area. Entirely predating the Cambrian explosion, the fossil finds were astounding in both quality and quantity, and they gave biologists an incredibly detailed look at the missing link between pre- and post-Cambrian explosion life. These days, some key parts of the collection are on display at the South Australian Museum in Adelaide. And it's an awe-inspiring group of fossils, showing a huge variety of creatures dating to around 550 million years ago. Some are just simple organisms like sponges, while others were able to move about under their own power. There's a huge variety of sizes as well, ranging from tiny fingernail sizes to coin-sized, hand-sized, and even some larger ones too, up to a meter across. There's clear signs of semi-complex life here, with primitive skeletons, brains, and digestive systems too, the building blocks of the entire animal kingdom. It's genuinely impressive stuff, and it's quite humbling to realize that almost all life on Earth has evolved from these primitive sea creatures, the world's oldest known animals. And it was so crucial to understanding the story of evolution that an entire geological time period, the Ediacaran, is now named after the area where the fossils were first discovered.
Wow,
Well, that's it from me here at the Flinders Ranges. It's such a magnificent landscape, like you can see behind me, and it's just so important to the history of life on Earth as well, that I really hope it does become a proper World Heritage Site in the near future, and I'm sure you'll agree with me as well. But thank you very much for watching. I'm Joel on the road. Leave me a thumbs up if you liked the video. Hit subscribe if you'd like to see more from the World Heritage Journey. We'll see you next time.